Hi friends, it's Peggy from prettypapercards.com, and I'm coming to you today to show you a little video tutorial on how to make a card, an easy card from the Cake Soiree bundle. This is one of the new bundles in our new 2018 occasions catalog, and it is fabulous. It has gorgeous stamps and you can do a lot with it. But I wanted to show you today a super easy card. This is quick and easy. That's why I wanted to show it to you on a quick video. Here's the card. Isn't that cute? And we are going to use the Sweet Soiree Embellishment Kit. Here it is. The Sweet Soiree Embellishment Kit. And I'm going to show it to you in just a moment and put the camera down and show it to you in the catalog. But this kit has all kinds of little already cut dies and vellum, silver on vellum, that make this card. Here I've stamped my little envelope a little bit with one of the stamps. But all of these things that you see here, those all come in the embellishment kit. So this is a super easy card to make. So let's do it. I'm going to turn the camera down and show you how to make this card. Okay, here we go. There we go, I think. And here you see prettypapercards.com up at the top, so you can go on my blog at any time. Okay, and here's the card we're going to make today. Let's make sure you can see that. Okay. I wanted to open the new catalog and show you the catalog for a minute. So this is the Occasions catalog, and this stamp set is fabulous. It has a full two-page spreads all about this stamp set. These are all different suggestions of what you can make, how you can make it. And then on this page, here's a picture of the stamp set and the dies that come with it, although we're not going to use the dies today. The paper, I'm hoping you can see the paper there. I'll push that up a little bit. There, the papers. And this is a better picture of what's in the embellishment kit that we're going to use today. It's super cute. It's only $11 and it helps you to make a really fast card. We're also going to be using the silver baker's twine today. I just love this silver baker's twine. I think I'm on my second roll because it's so great. So let's get started. We'll take another quick look at the card, the sample card. Now for this one, I stamped with one of the flower stamps. This set has four different kind of cabbage rose stamps, 1, 2, 3, 4, and I decided to use this one to create a background for my card. And on this one, I stamped it in Pear Pizzazz color, a light green. But for ours today, I thought I'd do something different. I'm going to use Berry Burst. This is one of my favorite colors right now, one of our in colors for this year. And here's that silver baker's twine. And these, again, are just items from that embellishment kit. And then I use the For You sentiment from the stamp set. I'll show it to you right here. And I just punched that out with a punch. So we're going to do that starting now. Okay. So the first thing I do is I have a card base. And if you make cards very much, you know that your card base is, you can have different ones, but this particular one is 8.5. by 8.5 by 5.5. And then you fold it in half to create your card. So your card front is actually 4.25 by 5.5. And what I usually like to do, and I'm gonna teach you this today, is I always think it looks nice to put an additional piece on top, a piece of white cardstock or whatever color on top, cut in 1/4 inch on all sides. I really think it just adds to the kind of formality, the niceness of the card, and it allows you to run a ribbon or baker's twine underneath, and it doesn't show inside. So we're going to start with this piece, which is 4 by 5 1/4. And we're gonna make our background using the Berry Burst ink, classic Stampin' Pad. And here's my stamp. Now this is a clear stamp. And what that means is it's a red rubber stamp that we attach to a clear block. So I'm just gonna ink that stamp up, and I am just gonna be very arbitrary about where I stamp it. It really isn't a big deal. And I always look under my stamps in case there's any ink that collects on the edges like that. I like to get it off so that it won't, you know, make a boo-boo on my paper. So I'm just gonna arbitrarily stamp all over using this Cabbage Rose stamp. I think it makes a really nice background. And I'm really not making a big deal of it, like that one didn't completely stamp on the edge, but I'm just not caring about it because this is just a pretty arbitrary background. I'm kind of keeping the roses a little bit farther apart so that it's just a light background. It's not a super busy background. Okay, so that's our background, very quick. Next, I'm going to tie my bow using my silver baker's twine. Really, this is so gorgeous. And I'm just going to tie it around. Tying bows can sometimes be daunting, but if I can do it with my long nails, you can do it. I promise you. And I'm just going to come around like this. I always cut, for me personally, I cut off plenty of ribbon. Or baker's twine. I want lots to play with, and I guess someone could say, well, Peggy, you waste a lot, but I want to know for sure. I want to have plenty for what I'm doing. So first, I make a knot. Just like that. Okay. Now I see that this one is all twisted up, so I'm going to pull that out to kind of straighten that baker's twine. Then I just tie my bow, and I think the key to bow tying is being patient and just fussing with it a little bit. Just, you know, let it work for you, although this one is coming out really great the first time. Sometimes they like to twist, but that's a pretty good bow for a quickie. Okay, so there's the bow. Now the next thing we're going to do, I'm going to pull it up, I'm going to say about a third of the way up the card. Okay, and I see that I do have a little bit of ink there, and so when I put everything over, all my different embellishments from the embellishment kit, I'm going to try to cover that. We all make mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes, and we always say in stamping there are no mistakes in stamping. We can always cover it up or fix it. So here are the different embellishments, and isn't this gorgeous? That is a die-cut piece of vellum that's already been, can you see that? Embossed with foil, or however they've done it. And this is why this is so easy. You don't have to do any of this. This is another die-cut piece. Isn't that pretty? And these are some little tiny leaves. These all come in the kit. I mean, it saves you so much time. Look at that. And we're just going to attach these. So the first one I'm going to do is this larger vellum flourish. And I use the Tombow Multi-Purpose Liquid Glue. Now normally, if this would show, I might do something different, but this is gonna be covered up, so I'm using the Tombow glue, and I'm just gonna stick it right under there like that. And then I'm going to put this one on top in a way that just, I think I'm gonna cover that little dot. Well, let's see, I might cover it with something else. I think I'll cover it with something else, and I'm just going to set this here. Now for this colored flourish, I'm going to use my Stampin' Dimensionals. I use a lot of dimensionals, and I think it really makes a very professional looking card. I'm going to put two dimensionals on this piece. You pull off the paper backing, and then I'm just going to tuck it right in there like that. Okay. Next, I'm going to put on some of these little tiny leaves. And for these, I'm just going to put a little white glue, a little of the Tombow white glue right under there, just a little bit, and it's not going to show because I'm going to, this one, I'm going to tuck under here. Well, let's see, and I'm hopefully going to cover that little boo-boo. There. Okay, that turned out great. Now we're going to use, we've got two more, and I just put these around to kind of create a balance. I mean, seriously, how easy is this? So I think I'll have one come out from up here, so I'm just going to pull up that little embellishment and stick that under. And it's just glued down at the bottom, so it can maybe lift a little on the edge, which is nice, because it gives it a little more depth to the card. Now, I think I need one right up. Well, let's go here. Okay, so I'm just going to put that down. Press it down so the glue sticks. Is that quick or what? Speedy. Okay, now we're done with that. Now we're going to stamp our sentiment, which is for you. Let me see. There it is. For you from the same stamp set. And this is going to be easy because we're going to punch it out with, oh boy, I've got some ink over there. I'll be more gentle this time, okay? Let's see if we've got it all inked up. Okay, let's try. Okay, great. Quick and easy, and I'm going to punch it out with a 1.5-inch circle punch. Just slide it in here, and then I just make sure I balance, you know, get it in the center on all sides. Punch that out. We're going to raise this up on dimensionals also, and I'm going to tuck it right there. So I'm just going to use, I think I like to use one dimensional when I'm going over a piece of ribbon or baker's twine. I like to use one dimensional on the top and one on the bottom, so hopefully the twine will go in between. Okay, let's do that. And we'll just center it right in there for you. Darling, right? Now all that we have to do is put it on our card. Now our card was like this, and I had scored it here, and then I pressed it, and I'm going to press it down again with my bone folder to make sure it gets nicely folded. And again, I'm going to use more dimensionals to raise this piece up. I think it just looks, it looks nicer on your card. So I'm going to put one dimensional in each corner, a little bit in from the corner so it doesn't, so nobody sees it, and then one in the center. You can use two in the center, but I do try to not be overboard with them because I don't, they do cost money and I don't want to waste them. So one seems to work for me. Okay, we peel those off and then we just center that and pop it right down. And there's your card. I do like it in the berry burst. What do you think? Whoops, let me get that little guy off of there. Very cute. Now, one thing I really like to do, and the people that come to my classes, we've all gotten in the habit of stamping a little bit on the inside. I prefer to write on the inside of my cards, but I like to give a little taste of what's on the outside on the inside. So I'm going to put one of these little roses right down here. I just think that looks cute. And then on my envelopes, I always like to do something, if I have time, on the outside of my envelope. And there are all kinds of things you can do. You could, we could stamp the cabbage rose on the back where the flap adheres. We could stamp a little, you know, grouping of cabbage roses, but for today, I'm just going to do one. Okay, and there's our project all finished. That took us maybe 10 minutes. And the reason was because we had all of these fabulous items from the Sweet Soiree embellishment kit. And that's why I wanted to show it to you today, because this is a really speedy card. I've already made, this is my fifth card with this embellishment kit, so you can make quite a few. I would say you could make a good 6 cards, and that's doubling up all of these items. Isn't that cute? Now, one other thing I want to show you before we go is I am, I just debuted today, just opened today, one of my online classes. It's for the end of February, and you can join the class up until February 26th, 2018. And it's a class on using the Southern Serenade stamp set, which I am loving. And the class, in the class, you will make three different cards designed by me using this stamp set, and I provide you with all the papers and a video tutorial and three PDF tutorials, one for each card. And all you do is buy a few things, including this stamp set. And in order to join the class, you order these things using my host code for the month. And as soon as you order the items for the class, I will see it and I will acknowledge that. And then I'll be sending out all the ingredients, all the papers and everything to and the tutorials. In order to join the class, just go on my blog, prettypapercards.com. Under classes, online classes, and you'll see all the details, and it'll tell you exactly what to order. And be sure and do it quick, because I only have the class open for 1 week, because I can only take so many. So be sure to join this week. And so that's it. Thank you so much. I'm going to put this card back up for you to enjoy on the screen, and thank you for stopping by for this tutorial. Okay, see you next time. Bye-bye.